Hey guys, this is Ben with Pulsar 2121. In this episode, we are going to install a smoked and tinted brake light. Stay tuned. Okay, so here we have our bike rack that we installed in the last video, and this is the tail light. There is a place to mount it. I think it's usually used for a license plate, maybe. But anyway, you can see that the place where you mount it isn't wide enough. So we're going to use this little computer PCI slot block off plate here. We're gonna cut that and drill in some holes, and then we'll be able to bolt the taillight to that and then bolt the adapter plate to the existing mounts. All right, I got the metal loaded up in the vise here. Gonna go ahead and just cut this off with the cutoff tool and watch the sparks fly. Here we go. That was so unnecessary, but so much more fun than a hacksaw. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and clean off these burrs here with the bench grinder and the brush. All right, that's looking pretty good. Now I'm gonna take this back inside and do some drilling. Okay, so now that we have our plate here, we're going to use the existing hole and then line it up so we can mark where we're gonna drill the new hole. We want that as far to the outside of the threads as we can get so we get an accurate mark on the other side. There we go. Oh my god, what happened to this drill bit? There, that's better. Okay, so now that we have both of our holes drilled and we have this bracket lined up, you can see we're going to need a hole for the wires to come out of. It's gonna have to be pretty large. So we're just gonna go ahead and mark that right there. And then we are going to drill another hole for the wires. All right, now we're gonna check that. Okay, so our wires line up pretty good. However, you can see that we have a little bit of an issue with this rubber grommet, and we can't drill a big enough hole for the grommet because then it's going to just tear apart the plate with this drill bit. So what I'm gonna do here is put in some more nuts here and here to space it out a little bit further. So then it'll be just parallel all the way across here. There'll be a nut, grommet, nut. And then on this side, we'll have another nut and another nut, which attaches the plate to the light. And then we're gonna drill some more holes here and here so we can attach it to the bike rack. First, we're gonna mark these inside holes. Alright, so now I'm just checking to make sure that our new block plate adapter thing, whatever this is now, I'm making sure this lines up with the holes, and it looks like it does. So I'm gonna go ahead and attach that. Alright, there we go. Alright, now that we've gotten this installed, you can see that our hole that we drilled for the wires is being blocked off by the original mounting place. So what we're going to do is re-drill this hole. There, all done. Okay, so as you can see, the hole over on the right here is wide open. It's no longer halfway blocked. However, this side is totally blocked, which is actually better because it's a lot harder to drill a half a hole. So what we're gonna do is just leave that side alone and then we're gonna re-drill this side. There we go. Okay, so now we can go ahead and fish these wires and then bolt up our light for the last time. Oh crap. Need my nuts. All right. There we go. We have our brand new brake light. All right, thanks for watching today, guys. As you noticed, it took a little bit longer than expected to make this video, which is pretty normal, honestly, when it comes to metal fabrication. That's just the way it is whenever things aren't supposed to be that way and you have to make them fit, which we did. Anyway, the taillight's looking awesome. It's going to be functional. It's going to be safe. Ish. No, nothing about this bike's going to be safe. It's going to be less likely to kill you than the other things on the bike. Anyways, make sure you click subscribe if you haven't already, and then click that little bell notification so you're notified when we have the next video. I think the next one is going to be that big electrical work video that I was talking about, so stay tuned for that, and I'll see you guys next time.